Whole person care is simply the combination of the curing, fixing part of medicine, at which we've become so good, along with the healing part of medicine. And the difference between them is, for the curing part, physicians and nurses and professionals, they're the ones who are doing the stuff and they're the ones who have the expertise. On the healing side, you're really using the patient's potential. And our job is, how do we facilitate healing? Medical students coming into medical school are completely open to that and have already had a sense of that. And it's part of why this is why they thought they were getting into medicine, to participate in this combination of scientific intervention and human support. If we can bring that process into the rest of medicine, it's what's missing. Because I don't think, just as patients are dissatisfied a lot of the time, doctors and nurses are dissatisfied a lot of the time. Because practicing medicine like a technological endeavor with efficiency and possibly financial concerns as the primary objectives is just not satisfying. It doesn't give you back what you need in order to sustain you in this work. And that's what I found for myself, that surprisingly, I was afraid to go into palliative care. I thought, I'll become depressed. All these people are dying. Totally opposite. I found, now I understand where the energy of medicine is. And it's exactly what our medical students come knowing. That's what they're looking for. And I think myself, at some level, that's what all physicians, all nurses are looking for. And some people have given up or they don't know how to find it. You know. So I think there's a huge potential there. And I think it'll be good for the profession, for patients, for healthcare practitioners. There's also a risk. If palliative care, so we want to take it to the rest of medicine. The risk is also, though, that the rest of medicine may squeeze palliative care in ways that turns it into something very like the rest of medicine. And that's already happening too. So while whole person care is expanding into the rest of medicine also tends to squeeze palliative care. And that's a potential problem. So just a simple example. You would think that in a palliative care unit, length of stay would not be a major concern. You know, that you wouldn't be looking at statistics and saying, our length of stay is 14 days versus 12, we got to get it down to 12. You would think the idea, and as I understood it, the idea of St. Christopher's Hospice was, this is a safe place to die. You're coming here, we're expecting, you know, you look like you're dying. But to run a palliative care unit, like with that efficiency model that works, does it work, I'm not sure, but that's applied in the rest of the hospital is not a good idea. Because what you end up doing is after 12, 13, 14 days, you start to ask, well, so-and-so is not dying, where are they going to go next? Well, if you can imagine yourself as a patient, if I can imagine myself, the huge step to go to palliative care, excellent care, this is where I'm going to die. And then if you haven't died in the required time, somebody's talking about where you're going to be transferred. That, to me, is the rest of medicine, squeezing palliative care.